Good evening friends, today I am going to discuss about different epipedals. As we know, there are 9 epipedals. Remember, epipedal is nothing but it is the diagnostic surface horizon. In similar way, endopedal is nothing but it is the diagnostic subsurface horizon. Diagnostic surface horizons are known as epipedals and diagnostic subsurface horizons are known as endopedals. As we know, there are 9 epipedals. First one is forestric, second one is histric, melanic, mollic, umbric, ochric, anthropic, plagain and grosserine. This is the last one. And remember, this epipedal term taken from Greek language. Epi means over or upon, pedal means soil. Okay, epipedal term taken from Greek language. Epi means over or upon, pedal means soil. And now I am going to discuss about each and every epipedal. So coming to foliastic, remember the main difference between foliastic and histric epipedal is saturation. The main difference between foliastic and histric epipedal is saturation. Remember, this particular foliastic epipedal never saturated with the water for more than 30 days. Remember, this is never saturated with water. Never saturated with water for more than 30 days. But coming to histric epipedal, this can be saturated with water, saturated with water for 30 days or more. And if you see another features of forestric epipedal, very less bulk density. And if you see the thickness of forestric epipedal, which is 15 cm or more. This is about forestric epipedal. Remember, mostly all forestric epipedals are having organic soil material and which remain saturated for less than 30 days. Coming to histric epipedal, this can be saturated for 30 days or more. And another main important feature of histric epipedal is which is having more organic matter. The following epipedal which is having high organic matter, so that is histric epipedal. And coming to melanic epipedal is nothing but it is the black color thick horizon. It is black color thick horizon and which is having anting properties. This is one of the very important bit. This particular epipedal having anting properties, this is important bit for JRF and SRF examination. So which of the following epipedal had anting properties? So that is melanic epipedal. Remember, anting properties are nothing but this particular soil developed from the volcanic ash material and which is having less bulk density and more amount of iron and aluminium, and this particular horizon or this particular soil can fix more phosphorus. So these all are, we can say, anting properties. So melanic epipedal main feature is this particular epipedal had anting properties. And coming to mollic epipedal, remember the main difference between mollic and umbric epipedal is base saturation. Base saturation is the major difference between the mollic and umbric epipedal. If you see the base saturation percentage for mollic epipedal, which is greater than 50%, and coming to umbric epipedal, which is less than 50%. And another features of mollic epipedal is, remember, this is dark colored halogen and soft mineral halogen. Soft mineral halogen. And this particular epipedal molding had strong structure. This is one of the very important. So the following epipedal which is having strong structure, so that is molded epipedal. And coming to umbric, so as we discussed, umbric epipedal having less than 50% base saturation and high CN ratio. High CN ratio, and this particular epipedal saturated with H plus ions. Saturated with H plus ions. So this is about molding and umbric. And coming to ochric epipedal. Remember, this particular ochric epipedal do not meet definition of any other epipedals. And remember, this ochric epipedal having less than 1% of organic matter. Less than 1% of organic matter. And remember, this particular ochric epipedal is light color epipedal. Why? Because which is having less than 1% of organic matter. And coming to anthropic epipedal and plagian epipedal. Remember, the main difference between the anthropic and plagian epipedal is anthropic epipedal formed due to continued cultivation, or we can say farming, or we can say fertilization. Okay, anthropic epipedal formed due to continued cultivation or farming or fertilization. But coming to plagian epipedal formed due to continued manuring. This is one of the very important bit for JRF. Which of the following epipedal formed due to continued manuring? That is plagging. Which of the following epipedal formed due to continued cultivation or farming? That is anthropic epipedal. And remember, this plagging is man-made epipedal and thickness is greater than 50 cm. But remember, the main difference between the molding epipedal and anthropic epipedal is this particular molding epipedal is having less than 1500 mg citric acid soluble P2O5 per kg soil. But coming to anthropic epipedal, which is having 1500 mg citric acid soluble P2O5 or more than 1500 milligram citric acid soluble P2O5 per kg soil. Okay, and coming to grosser end, this is the sandy halogen. We can say this is sandy halogen. The thickness is 100 cm or more. And if you see the nature of grosser end, that is loamy fine sand and coarser. So if you see the nature of grosser end, that is loamy fine sand or coarser nature, and this particular epipedal situated above the argillic endopedal. This is all about epipedals. Here in epipedals you have to remember some points for JRF and SRF examination. First of all, difference between anthropic and plagian. Anthropic epipedal formed due to continued cultivation, but coming to plagian epipedal formed due to continued manuring. So beside that, plagian epipedal show the spade marks also, and we can see artifacts in the plagian epipedal such as bits of pottery and bricks. And difference between umbric epipedal and molding epipedal. As we discussed, molding epipedal is having greater than 50% base saturation. Coming to umbric, which is having less than 50% of base saturation. So remember, ochric epipedal is having less than 1% of organic matter. But coming to molding epipedal is having 1% of organic matter or more.